Mayor Rocky Anderson.
Thank you very much. Representative Pence and Professor Presser made a comment upon which all of the rest of their following comments was based, and that is that impeachment is to be limited only to those instances where the person being impeached exercised his or her own personal interest above that of the nation. That is atrocious scholarship. It does not reflect what's happened in history. It does not reflect what the founders had to say or the comments made during the ratification convention regarding impeachment. Ed Firmage, who is co-author of To Chain the Dog of War, still the seminal book on the war powers, wrote an article in 1973, Law Review article, about substantive law of impeachment. There he noted that clearly charges of constitutional violations, and here there certainly have been many discussed, and gross abuses of power for illegitimate purposes should be included as impeachable offenses regardless of the offender's office. And then Professor Firmage goes on to cite this committee, the Judiciary Committee, a statement in 1926, where the Judiciary Committee noted that the better sustained and modern view is that the provision for impeachment in the Constitution applies not only to high crimes and misdemeanors, as those words were understood at common law, but also acts which are not defined as criminal and made subject to indictment, but also to those which affect the public welfare. Thus, an official may be impeached for offenses of a political character and for gross betrayal of public interests, also for abuses of betrayal of trusts, for inexcusable negligence of duty, for the tyrannical abuse of power, or as one writer puts it, for a breach of official duties. That has been established beyond any doubt. And I would add just one other thing in terms of the misrepresentations. I would say fraud committed by, we can't name anybody by name here, so I would say by the administration or a high-ranking official of the administration. And that is when this Congress and the American people were told about the security risks to this country posed by Iraq and by the case for war, we were only told one part of the story. We were not told, for instance, besides some of the reports that were noted before, about the dissents by the intelligence agency within the State Department and by the Department of Energy. Their statements in the October National Intelligence Estimate that said there is nothing to back this up about these aluminum tubes being used to help Iraq's supposed nuclear initiative, and there certainly is nothing to this claim about Iraq trying to buy uranium from Niger. It was right there in the National Intelligence Estimate. The president, high-ranking members of the administration, as they were telling we the American people and you the Congress, just the opposite, failed to disclose those dissenting opinions from the State Department and the Department of Energy. That constitutes a fraud which helped lead this country to this disaster in Iraq.
Professor Stephen Presser.